This is definitely different from how hackers normally get your information, because here what we're talking about is we're dealing with so-called side channels, which means that the computer is transmitting information even though it's not meant to transmit.
They're called side channels because they're not meant to be there. So essentially any electronic activity that generates a current fluctuation, it's creating the signal that is related to activity in the machine.
There are a lot of applications that, as a result of your typing, do a lot more work. For example, the word processors that do the spell checking and grammar checking and so on, it turns out that you can actually hear the signal. So every time a key is pressed, you can actually hear on the radio the signal that comes from the spell checking activity. And then as you press the space bar, the grammar check is going to be updated because now you have one more word. And that results in a lot more activity because grammar is more complex to check than just does it match a valid word.
Essentially, we're measuring which instruction leaks the most. And that's important information if you want to do software analysis to find out which part of your code is the most vulnerable for snooping and avoid certain instructions if you're doing anything related to a password, for example.
A current creates an electromagnetic field, and changes in current create a varying electromagnetic field, which is what the antenna is picking up. So the antenna is pretty much by induction receiving the variation in the EM field that is produced by the changes in current. And that means that as your processor activity and memory activity changes, there will be changes in the currents, which translate into the changes in the electromagnetic field, and that means that there is a signal picked up by the antenna.
So this project is about analyzing and quantifying vulnerabilities of side channel attacks in electromagnetic domain. We want to analyze the signals, understand where they're coming from, how strong they impact the computation, and try to find the measures that would help both software and hardware engineers solve this problem.